Our next speaker is Paul Dura. Paul has a PhD from NYU Poly, and he'll be talking about advanced persistent threat. Thank you.
Thanks, Gus. Thank you. So today I'll talk about APT. We heard about APT since early morning today in the intro video. So what is APT, first of all? It's commonly thought that APT is a cyber attack that is targeting organization information mainly. But I think the a better definition of the APT is given by the words that make up the acronym. It's advanced. It's an advanced attack because the attackers use very sophisticated tools and they are very skilled in what they do. It's persistent because the attack is persistent and stealthy over long periods of time. And it's a threat mainly because it's highly targeted and is operated by humans rather than being random behavior of a piece of malware. Now, there are some well-known instances of these attacks. Even though they are quite different from one to the other, most of them share some common stages of the attack. So the first stage of this type of attacks requires the reconnaissance. And this represents the phase in which the attackers gather information about targeted organization. The second stage is represented by the delivery of the piece of malware that will be used in the attack. And in this stage, attackers craft the special phishing email and create a trustworthy content of the email in order for the employees to open that email. The third stage is the exploitation stage, which is represented by the fact that the piece of malware is run on the organization premises. And actually, in this stage, the attacker takes control over the machine inside the company. The fourth stage is the operation stage, where the attacker scans the internal assets of the organization and tries to identify the targeted sources of data. The fifth stage is the data collection, when the attackers gather information from inside the company. And the last stage is the exfiltration, where the data collected in the previous stage is actually sent out of the network, in most cases overseas. So looking at this general description of the problem, we try to come up with a formal representation and to understand better this type of attack. And we model this attack starting with the threat trees, which were introduced in 1994 by Ed Amoroso in his famous book, Fundamentals of Computer Security. The basic idea in a threat tree is to place at the root of the tree the final goal of the attack. And then the children of each node in the tree represent the way in which the attacker can reach the goal that is in the parent node. In this figure is represented a simple threat tree example of an attack that is targeting customer data. It's very simplistic, but just to make the point, in the left side, we can see the ways in which the attacker can reach the final goal in the physical plane. And in the right side, we can see the ways in which the attacker can reach the final goal, the customer data, in the network plane. So being able to build this kind of threat tree is useful not only in evaluating the risk of each individual asset in the company, but also gives a hint to the organization where to place the security mechanism in the infrastructure in order to catch the attack in early stages of the attack, which is very important. However, this model, even though it's very powerful, cannot keep up with the complexity of an APT, and this is why we propose a new enhanced model, which is the attack pyramid. Basically, the idea is to place the goal of the attack, the possible goal of the attack, at the top of the pyramid, and then the environments where the attack can evolve in the organization to be represented by the lateral planes of the pyramid. In this way, we have a global view of what is going on within an organization. And if we unfold this pyramid, we actually get some structure similar with what is a threat tree, with the main difference that in each path from the initial stages of the attack to the final goal, we have events that can be captured across many planes. So this gives us a clue that the attack is going on even without waiting for the attack to reach the goal, the sensitive information. Now, having this model, we propose a detection framework. And the first step is to identify the possible APT goals within an organization. And this can be the intellectual property, the customer data, business data, resources to run the business, and so on. The second step is to consider the building the attack pyramid to give us the understanding of what assets are at risk and where we can catch the events that can lead to the detection of the attack. And this can be the physical plane, which are associated with the physical premises of the company, the user plane, network plane, application plane, and so on. These are just some examples. The third step is to profile legitimate usage by looking at the security policies within a company and the known APT attack scenarios. And the fourth stage, which is the most important, try to correlate all these events in all the planes and try to detect the APT attack in a context, which can be the employee, which has the more weight in the company or within the data that can be targeted, like customer data or resource context. Sorry. So I'm actively working on this project with another six colleagues of mine, Wei, that presented earlier, Ramesh, Ilona, Andrea, Charles, and Jeff. That's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Paul.